Unidentified object.
All planes should have been out of this area 20 minutes ago.
Transcontinental Flight 17, he's off course.
Will he hold us up?
No, he'll be clear before launching.
3 minutes, 30 seconds.
You better be clear. I hear that satellite cost us $9 million.
Yeah, it'd be just great if she sideswiped an airliner. 3 minutes, 15 seconds.
The skies are clear.
3 minutes.
Power on.
And man is finally ready to move into space.
Colonel Tomlinson, I'd like to have you meet Dr. Anderson. I assume you two gentlemen have known of each other.
Doctor, it's rare to meet so illustrious a physicist as...
Thank you, General. I'm pleased. But I'm sure you're just as distressed at my presence here as Secretary Platt.
Oh, I wouldn't say distressed.
No, certainly not, Mr. Platt. We're all in a state of high hilarity. And we'll all wind up in a state of high mortality if you don't call off this satellite project.
How many times have I told you that's impossible?
Not nearly as many times as I've warned the government against such a course. I said it when I was head of the perpetual missile program. I said it before that when I was working on the Manhattan Project in War II. Don't tell me you haven't read my papers on the subject.
You've had a remarkable career, Doctor. Every degree imaginable. By the way, just what are you doing at present? Retired, I understand?
That's one way of putting it. The world is full of fat heads, Mr. Secretary. Full to overflowing.
I've got a great deal of respect for you, Dr. Anderson. But this has not convinced me the satellite is a menace to the safety of the world.
What happened to the first one? The small one?
It exploded in its own orbit.
Anyone know why?
Nobody.
I know why. It was a warning. I anticipated that fully 3 years before the satellite was launched.
Doctor, you said something about the other planets wanting to keep the Earth in its place?
To keep her out of the skies.
But there's no life in the other planets of this system.
I'm not arguing theory, General. I'm only telling you this. Alien intelligence watches us constantly. It will see this satellite of yours and know something must be done. I'm here to ask you, to beg you, to save your own world.
Well, Doctor, this has become just an academic question. In about 8 seconds, the sphere will be launched. They're in the countdown right now.
Did you bake it yourself?
Oh, sure. An old family recipe my grandmother sold at the bakery. Mm-hmm. Tom, you want some more?
Only half a gallon, Missile.
What are you acting so smug about? You look like a man who just inherited Texas.
You might not be too far off in a sense.
Tom?
Yes, dear.
I know. I bet you finally decided you were wrong about the satellite.
Hardly. It's my greatest interest in life. Second greatest.
Well... been up there for 3 months now, and nothing horrible has happened. 80 feet in diameter, 1,070 miles high, and circling the Earth at 16,000 miles an hour.
Oh, look. Can't you two talk about anything else? I'm getting tired of hearing about nothing but satellites, isotopes, conical graduations, and all the rest. Maybe you've got something in space medicine I could use for a headache, huh?
Well, you have got something up your sleeve. What is it?
I can't tell you, Paul. My wife won't let me. She thinks I'm crazy.
The whole world thinks you're crazy, maybe even me. Now, what's the big secret?
Well?
Tom, please.
Honey, this is too big.
But you promised.
Paul will understand. Maybe nobody else on Earth, but Paul will understand.
I'll try.
Come into the other room.
Don't take it so hard, Claire.
See what you've got.
Come on, I'll wash and you wipe.
Oh, good as one by the kit.
It'll be just a second.
I've got a second.
There, do you have any idea what you're listening to?
London Philharmonic?
It's Venus.
Huh?
Venus.
Not. We've bounced signals off the moon's surface. There's no reason that Venus shouldn't radiate impulses.
I don't mean the static.
Get
Can't you hear it, the other thing?
What other thing?
Listen to it, Paul. Listen to the voice.
Hello. Paul Elton here. What? Well, that's impossible. Yes, I'll be right down.
Something wrong at the installation?
It's gone.
What's gone?
The satellite. It took off on a direct tangent into space. It's vanished.
You better get over there.
Joan!
What is it, Paul?
Some trouble at the installation. We have to run.
Good night, Cliff.
Good night.
I know what you're thinking, Tom. I don't appreciate it.
I always thought Tom was a little off, but tonight he went too far.
Tom's a genius. Too much so, but I got more important things to worry about. Let's go.
Any change, Sergeant?
No, sir.
I think maybe the general ain't so happy tonight.
Raise the gain on the audio. We might hear something.
It's a full decibel now.
The scientific achievement of the century has disappeared. We've got to find it.
Keeps up, I think we should get a turnstile.
It's back. Maybe the instruments failed, and maybe they didn't. Anyway, we're gonna find out.
Sorry, Doctor.
Well, it wasn't your fault, Ellen. Now be sure you get the reports to Washington before morning.
Yes, sir.
Tell them we're bringing the satellite down for full examination.
Yes, sir.
Can you handle recovery procedure all right by yourself?
All I have to do is wait till she's at 43 North, push a couple buttons.
Secretary Platt is going to want to know where she went and why. That means examination of every instrument on board. If anything else goes wrong, call me at home.
Right. Good night, Doctor.
Good night.
Anderson, acknowledge. Where are you? Yes, yes. It's true, I am your only friend. Nobody else even knows you exist. But they will. It'll be the greatest day in the history of mankind.
Come to bed, Tom.
He's here, darling. He drew the satellite to his world, to Venus. And now he's back, within an hour. He's inside that circling laboratory, just waiting to come down to us, to save us.
Please come to bed. You'll feel better in the morning.
I'm signing off now. I'll reopen contact after sunrise.
Don't let it get a hold of you, Tom. You've dreamed and imagined for such a long time. Don't let your imagination bring itself to life.
This is no image, darling. It's what I've been predicting for years. And this is good instead of evil. That was my one uncertainty.
Well, don't think about it now. You need some sleep.
I'm gonna stay by the set tonight.
Whatever you say, Tom. Good night.
Good night.
You're positive you know what you're doing?
Oh, I think we can manage without wrecking it too much.
Well, what am I worried about? I'm not paying for it. They're ready, Mr. Secretary.
All right. Nothing to do now but bring it down.
I've got the car waiting downstairs.
Proceed with the operation.
Roger. 30 seconds.
Position 42 north, 58 minutes. 59 minutes, 43 north. Locking and locked.
Decelerating.
4 gravities.
Too slow.
6 gravities.
Should be past 28 by now.
Something wrong?
Well, I don't know, General. The thing acts like it doesn't want to come down. Begin descent.
Dorsal rockets engaged. Abandoning orbit.
It's not responding.
What's happening?
I don't know, General. It's behaving very erratically.
Well, then send it back up. Don't experiment with it.
It's too late now, General. She's in pattern. Or supposed to be.
What's going to happen next?
I don't think I want to know.
Get Washington again, Carol.
Yes, sir. Communications.
Yes, yes, I hear you. He's alive, darling. He survived the crash.
Tom, you're a sick man.
The whole world's sick, darling. It always has been. But that's all over now. At last, every dream of man can be realized.
Stop it, Tom.
Would you get Paul on the phone? I've got to tell him.
I'm going into town. When I get back, I pray to God you'll be rational.
Claire. What's that?
Yes.
According to a rough triangulation, I put you in the mountains about 10 miles south of here.
You filled it last night.
I did. It's funny. It must be the battery or something. I'll have a look.
Paul, my watch has stopped.
I'll wind it up.
What's come over this place? Everything's gone haywire.
There's been a power failure someplace. I imagine they'll have it fixed in a few minutes.
Phone's dead, General.
It sure is quiet outside.
And it's always quiet in these mountains.
Not this quiet.
What happened to the satellite?
Oh, it's down. Just a little ways south of here. The signals were full of static, but still coming through when the power failed.
Gone. $9 million and 5 years' work.
No, I can't find anything.
Well, we can't just sit here for... Paul! Horrible.
They might want us as witnesses. What time is it?
Well, I've still got 3 past 3. The darn thing won't go.
Power clock is stopped, too. Same time.
I wonder why.
Coincidence?
No. I've got a premonition.
Well, I've got a stalled car. For once, I'm glad Tom pulled out here in the country. We'll walk up to his place. Maybe he'll drive us to a garage.
Might as well. We can't sit here all day.
Yes. I had the names of the key control people in this vicinity. Mayor of Beechwood... Andrew Townsend, Chief of Police, N.J. Shallett. Chief Security Officer for the installation, Brigadier General James Paddock. Head of the satellite project, Dr. Paul Nelson. Along with their wives, this makes a total of 8. Exactly the number of control devices you will be able to produce at this time. I'd like to see one of these devices. I presume they're electronic in function. ¶¶
not a car running in town. Screwy.
What's happening in the rest of the country, Mr. Haskell?
I don't know. The wire service broke down. Looks like this town was stranded in the midst of nowhere. Well, Mrs. Anderson, your husband said this thing was going to happen. Now ask him how well are we going to get out of it.
Yes, I'll be sure to.
Keep moving. Nothing to be afraid of.
Officer, my husband, he's in an iron lung. It stopped.
You get back in there and operate it by hand. I'll get help to you. Claire!
You're Anderson. I read your stuff. You did this.
You, haven't I got trouble enough with that? Somebody got
it. Are you hurt?
No, come on. I got the car parked on the edge of town.
Well, none of the other cars are working.
Ours isn't power control.
I thought you said Tom and Claire live nearby.
They do when you're driving.
What's that?
Well, I'm not going to stop to ask it.
What an ugly creature. I've never seen anything like it.
Yeah, neither have I. Must be some kind of cave bat. Remind me to ask Tom about it. He knows zoology.
Well, let's go. We'll never get there standing here. De-energize.
We stopped power at source. That means electricity, steam, water, combustion engines, everything.
Water? You mean the faucets won't work?
That's right.
Oh, that's nonsense.
Hey, cut that out.
Thought you said it wouldn't work.
Well, sure, that works. It belongs to me.
Miles up the road.
You chose the wrong day to go for a ride.
Can you run me down to Phil's garage?
I'm afraid that wouldn't do you any good, but I will ask you inside for a drink.
You look all in.
A drink I can use.
I'll get some ice.
What's your pleasure?
I'll have some bourbon and soda.
Somebody can just pour a bucket of water over my head and then shrink my feet.
What time did your car die?
3:03.
Well, that's when all the clocks stopped.
Mm-hmm.
Do you need anything else?
No, thank you, dear.
Wait a minute. How did you know the car died? Could have had a broken axle or anything.
Could have. It didn't. Ran down just like every other car did today.
Misery loves company, but that's carrying it too far.
What's going on?
Relax. You have plenty of time.
Heard anything from General Paddock?
Not a thing. Not since he left the headquarters an hour ago.
Took the Jeep, huh?
No, the Jeep don't run, so the General, he walks.
How are things going inside?
Power's still off. Funny thing, the auxiliary is a hand crank. That doesn't even work.
Wonder what effect all this is having on my wife's big mouth.
Let me know if you hear anything from the General.
Yeah, sure thing.
Myself to believe what you're saying.
It's nothing new. It's been years since anyone's believed me.
All right, let's assume you're right. A superior intelligence has come from Venus in my satellite. Established residency turned off the world's power and is about to take over the world's population. Why aren't you fighting it?
Because this superior intelligence happens to be a personal friend of mine. I believe he's here to rescue mankind, not to conquer it, as you have naturally concluded.
A personal friend of yours?
Real chums.
The days when people made fun of me are over, girls.
Rescue mankind from what?
From itself.
Oh. I didn't know we needed rescuing.
Remember your theory on contained gravitation?
How could I forget it?
You thought you could build a craft that would degravitate itself and so escape the Earth's draw without any fuel or engine of any kind.
Mm-hmm.
Good idea. What happened to it?
Washington red tape, couldn't get an appropriation.
So? Stupidity. An example of how stupidity restrains man's progress. I've been a continual victim of it myself. Stupidity, fear, greed.
And the new arrival is going to end all of this?
In so short a time, you hardly realize it's been done. I can't help feeling a sense of triumph, Paul. I'm in on the beginning of ultimate freedom. I predicted the possibility. I assist the benefactor.
How's he going to do it?
Can't tell you yet, Paul. It's premature. But you'll be with us very soon.
I don't think so, Tom. I'd have to take a long, hard look at anything that was going to change the world and me so completely. How about a lift to the lab?
No point in going there. It's inoperative and useless.
And will you drive us home?
Sure. Go out to the car. I'll be with you in a minute. Paul didn't panic. There's nothing quite like a logical, orderly mind.
He didn't panic because logic makes him think you're insane.
Don't ride me, Claire. I've forgiven your lack of faith for years. But now the facts are in front of you. It's time you stood by me.
I'll stand by you, Tom. Not just because I'm your wife, but because I love you.
You heard? Trace the energy of my car. It will lead you to Nelson's home. He's difficult, but his mind is of utmost value.
Everything in order, men?
Yes, sir.
Big news from headquarters. This whole area has been placed under martial law.
Golly.
They seem to think I should be in command of this sector and prepare defense measures.
Against what?
They didn't say. This place is to be abandoned, Neil. I want you, Manuel, and the rest of the installation guards to move out at 16:30 hours. You're going on a forced march.
Yes, sir.
Your reconnaissance. Take a position south of Baker's Ridge and observe the country to the east. But take no action.
Hey, Senor General. Sir, how are we going to know when it's 4:30? Nobody's watch is working.
Here, take mine. It's running again. Now assemble your gear and move out.
What good is that going to do? There's still no power.
I know it. Let's just say it keeps me off the street.
Oh, General Paddock, any news? Big news. We're in the midst of a communist uprising. They've sabotaged every power source in the area.
What? How'd they manage to hit all power at once? I can understand them getting the big electric and water plants, but none of the independent generators here are working.
And wristwatches.
And the flashlight. Well, don't ask me. I just know they did it.
How did you get the message? Radio and wires are dead as everything else.
A special courier got through from Fifth Army Command. I have orders to restrict everyone to this building until the emergency is over.
You mean we're prisoners?
Well, protective custody, so to speak. They'd like to get their hands on people with your fund of secrets.
Well, there's blankets and canned goods in the broom closet. We'll make out.
I'll have some supplies set over, but don't budge an inch.
Will you read you, General? Not an inch.
Well, guess we've got a lease.
Claire, you and Tom drop over real soon.
We'll be sure to, Joan.
I hope you haven't made a permanent enemy of Paul. You were really rough on him tonight.
It's no longer possible for me to make an enemy, darling. The word enemy is about to disappear from the human language.
What about the word tact?
Well, at least you get a day off.
We'll see about that.
Dad?
Yes, try the light switch.
Paul, do you think he could be right?
He couldn't be.
He said he predicted it.
In the 15 years I've known Tom Anderson, he's predicted everything a fertile imagination could. He's wasted his entire life on calculated fantasy. One or two of his dreams were bound to come true, if only because they're so all-encompassing.
Maybe this dream has come true.
No, a natural catastrophe has occurred, Joan. We'll find a reason for it. Tom is merely trying to attach one of his pet ideas to it. Don't you see, it vindicates him, proves to a laughing world that all of his whimsies are accurate.
I see. A chance to regain face.
Exactly.
The cave you were in is located over a hot spring. That is why you find it cohabitable with Venus. Paul Nelson's still at large. If he's not at his home, he may try to get to the satellite installation. It will take you 12 days to produce 8 new devices. Too bad there aren't more of you. What are my next instructions? Remain here until Beechwood is evacuated. Yes, sir.
Come on, come on, keep going. Out into the street. The evacuation must be accomplished by midnight.
Going.
Stay up here.
Faster, faster, move faster.
What's this all about? What's everybody running from?
It's the end of everything.
What do you mean?
Highway 18, let me go.
Oh, that's into the desert.
They set up a camp for us. Let loose of me. They're after us.
Who's after you? Vegas Ridge. We'll turn off here and watch cross country to the south. Hey, why don't you watch where you're going?
I seen a funny looking bird.
That was no bird. That was the guy in front of you. All right, let's move.
They're running from something. Maybe we should get out too.
No, I have an idea. That's the plan. Clear the town. Control panic.
Control? But Tom said it was...
Forget what Tom said. I've got to go up to the installation.
Oh, Paul, no.
I've got to, Joan. I can't stay here and watch the whole world fall apart. Can you get inside and lock everything up?
Oh, darling, I'm afraid something terrible will happen to you. Please don't.
Go on. And be sure you close the windows, every one of them. I'll be back as soon as I can.
Paul!
You're about the last man still in town, Mr. Haskell.
Well, looks like it. I'll probably be here for the rest of my day.
Please don't be difficult, editor.
You got a gun, Charlotte. That isn't like you. But gun or no gun, here I stay. I helped build this town. My paper got you your job for you, remember?
No need for papers now. They're nothing but a stack of ideas and notions. Useless. Get moving.
Sorry, but I'm staying.
Charlotte. Oh, Dr. Nelson. I've been hoping I'd see you.
Explain, what is this?
Orders, Doctor.
Whose orders?
His.
Charlotte, I've known you for 5 years. You just killed a man in cold blood. Why?
His orders. I'll have to place you under protective custody. You're to be one of us. Get up. You're free.
What are you doing now?
I finally learned from my friend the structure of the control devices. They fly to the persons wanted like birds. Might just see one.
How do they gain control of the victim?
Well, there are no victims, darling. You should rather call them the released. According to him, they have radiological electrode-type things in their beaks. They plant these in a person's neck, after which he is controlled by the benefactor. And like bees, once they have stung, so to speak, they die.
And the people? They don't die.
No.
Now, only their minds.
Their minds are clearer than they ever thought possible. Only the waste is gone. The hate, bitterness, dreams, all the foolish nonsense.
The emotion?
Yes, the emotion.
Why are you holding me?
Why? Because I love you. You know that.
I don't know why you should. It's a waste.
What?
It's an emotion. Tom, you can't rub the tarnish from men's souls without losing a little bit of the silver, too.
It has to be that way.
Tom, are you really ready to stop loving me?
Try to think clearly, darling. Why do people love? Because they see in another the answer to their needs. I see warmth in you and beauty. You're everything I must have as a man. And I'll need you even when no emotion exists.
Don't try and split canes with your wife, darling. For a few dollars, you can hire a woman who'll fit all your fetishes. She'll match your requirements perfectly. And then if you ever get tired of her, you can always run down to the employment agency for another.
Don't you believe in signs, Dr. Nelson?
General Paddock, you startled me.
Didn't mean to.
Well, why is the place shut down? Where is everybody?
They've been transported to the district air base. No telling what might happen to them here. May I give you a ride back to Beechwood? It's a long bike trip.
You certainly may, General.
You certainly may.
Let's get this in there. Whew. What a relief. That seat is built for the spanking size, and I'm a little bit beyond it.
How come this thing runs? New experimental model. You just wind it with a rubber band and hold it with your thumb. You know, I think it would be best if you and Mrs. Nelson would join your employees at the base.
Could be. Is there any way I can get in touch with them?
Not a chance. They're under protective custody.
General, don't you think we ought to get that rock out of the road before we start?
Huh? What rock?
Another drink or another ride?
You filthy murderer.
Well, that's a nice way to greet an old friend.
Did you tell me that you were a friend of this alien? Did you tell me you helped it?
Sit down, Paul. You're upset.
Now sit down and then you'll talk. I want to hear everything.
Now you're being reasonable. Yes, I helped him. I paved the way. Told him everything that would make it possible for him to come here.
There's only one?
There's only one on Earth. There are 9 altogether. The other 8 are still on Venus. They're the sole survivors of a race that was born too soon. It developed amid the eruptions and the boiling gases of Venus, a planet that won't catch up to Earth in perhaps 1 million years in climate.
A dying race.
Yes, but each of the 9 has an intellect that will dwarf humans, make us look like so many roaches by comparison.
And you think we need him?
We always have.
Listen, do you know that in the last 24 hours, men have had their minds, their personalities, their moral standards imprisoned? That a whole population has been herded like cattle into the desert? That men have been murdered for failing to obey the new master? It makes you think a little, doesn't it?
Yes. Makes me look back into history for a comparison.
Comparison or rationalization?
Listen, Paul. Throughout man's career, every great change, every sudden leap in his station has resulted in torment, chaos, and death. The French Revolution brought democracy to Europe. Plagues brought wondrous cures. Wars brought about fast planes, atomic power, radiological medicine, our own discoveries.
No, that won't hold. You're talking about human change, something you want to get rid of. Well, this thing isn't human, so your argument falls flat. And incidentally, I could point out an equal number of regressions and disasters that have been brought about by revolutions and plagues and wars.
I'm not convinced.
Well, neither am I of your hypotheses.
You will be. You must be. He wants you on his side. Next to me, he wants you.
And you want me to condone this reign of terror? To swear allegiance to this monstrous king of yours? To kill my own soul and all within reach? Well, I won't, Anderson. I'll fight it to the last breath in my body. And I'll fight you, too, because you're part of it. The worst part. Because you belong to a living race, not a dying one. This is your land, your world. Your hands are human, but your mind is enemy. You're a traitor, Anderson. The greatest traitor of all time. And you know why? Because you're not betraying part of mankind. You're betraying all of it.
You're proud.
He was my friend. Despite all our fights and disagreements, he was my best friend.
Is that all you can think of, as losing a friend? Didn't his words mean anything to you? If you weren't so blind, you'd realize that Paul was your friend today as he's never been before.
What do you mean?
Oh, you fool. Anybody who didn't care about you, who didn't believe there was still something in you worth trying to save, would have killed you on the spot.
Killed me?
Yes. Just as he'll find a way to kill your God. He had a gun. I saw it in his coat.
A gun?
That's right, Tom. You just had an undeserved stay of execution.
So you believe with him that I'm a traitor? You've turned against me all the way.
I've done nothing. Everything is up to you. You're the one who has to see for himself. I don't know. I guess I'm just a fool. I'm like Paul. I can't help believing that you're going to find yourself. I love you, darling, but I have pride. I want to love a good man, a fine man I married. I won't love a monster. I won't.
Don't cry, Claire. Believe me, I know what I'm doing.
Oh, Tom, stop it!
I hear you. Yes, Beechwood seems secure. Sir, I'm troubled. Maybe you haven't got that word in your sphere, but I must see you. Why not? Yes, I'll be patient, but Paul Nelson is still at large. That means that he, his wife Joan, Mayor Townsend, and his wife are the 4 not yet under control.
Thank you. Joan?
Home at last?
Mm-hmm. Hi.
Hi. Just had a shower. Be right with you. Where'd you go today?
First, I went downtown. I saw the chief of police kill George Haskell. And I went to the lab, and it was closed. I found General Paddock possessed. It's a horrible mess. I'll tell you about it when you come out.
Get it, sir.
Honey?
Mm-hmm?
How come the shower's working?
It's not. But after a while, I felt so tacky, I just had to do something. So I stuck a bucket full of water in the shower window and used the shampoo hose.
Sheer genius. Hey, come out here. I want to see you.
Since when can't you come in here?
Since I'm too tired to move.
All righty. I'll come out to you then. Oh, there's a draft on your neck. I don't want you to catch cold.
The window. I thought you'd keep it closed.
Well, it got stuffy in here. I had to have some air. Guess what I've got?
What?
A present for you. Good night, darling. I'm going for a short walk. When I get back, you'll feel much better.
I have the only working phone left.
What do you want?
I just talked to my friend. He said you killed the control device that was made for you.
So?
So that means you can't be controlled for over a week. Come on over. I want to talk to you. I want to apologize.
How will I get there?
Jones' station wagon will run.
All right, I'll come over. There's something I have to take care of first.
Good. I'll see you later. He's coming. Yes. Yes, it must be done.
What is it?
He said Paul is first of the mines to be taken. First because he is the most dangerous. He's the one enemy. The one great enemy because he knows basically what he's fighting. His control device is gone.
What does that mean?
It means he must die. He's too great a menace to live the weak. I'm supposed to kill him tonight.
Wouldn't take long.
You were right.
And now we must wait for him to give us instructions.
What sort of instructions?
Well, to conquer the world.
We'll be this way from now on, won't we?
For the rest of our lives.
I see.
Hurry up and wait.
We come all the way out here in the woods, so what do we do?
We're supposed to be observing suspicious actions, remember?
What kind of actions?
You tell me.
I told you, but you don't listen to me.
What are you talking about?
I told you I seen that funny-looking bird.
Bird. Will you forget about the bird already? That's all you've been talking about all day. All right, you guys, what is this, a picnic? You men with the dice, clean your rifles. Never mind the beeps, get busy.
Is that what you plan to use on Paul? You'd murder your best friend? Tom, if you do that, you'll be killing me with the same bullet. What's the matter? Has the cat got your tongue so you can't talk? Maybe your friend has it. You've given him everything else of you. Tom, are you afraid to talk to me? Are you just plain ashamed? Well, that must be it. Are you closing off your machine? Suppose your boss wants you to run down to town and cut out a few hearts. He might get mad when he can't reach you and snap his fingers. Has he got fingers? The master isn't going to like it when the servant turns off the juice. He might want to turn you into a white rat so that
That's
you can...
That's enough, Claire.
He speaks. The zombie speaks. That's right. Let's have some music. Must be great to have the only working phonograph in the world. A gift from His Majesty. It makes you feel like a big man, doesn't it? Just like you've always wanted to be.
Claire.
Yes?
What I have to do tonight is difficult enough. You're only making it harder on me.
I want it to be hard. Please, darling, open your mind for just a few minutes and let me get inside so I can talk to you.
I'm listening.
Tell me about this invader. Now, what's he like?
Well, I don't know much. He's strong or he wouldn't have been able to make the trip through space. He's advanced because he can talk to his controlled subjects at a distance. Of course, he's super intelligent. He's established at Elephant Hot Springs Cave because he needs a climate like that of Venus.
Hiding in a cave? Afraid of light? Well, then Earth must have no use to him except as a subject of conquest.
I said I'd listen and answer your questions. We'll argue about it later.
Why does he want you to kill Paul?
Because he was able to manufacture only 8 control devices for the 4 key control people in the vicinity and their wives.
Wives?
Yes. It was a pair for Paul and Joan. Paul killed his, which means we must do something about it.
Joan's been controlled?
Yes. There are only 3 on the list that were not. Paul, the mayor, and his wife.
But they're dead. They were killed in the crush of the evacuation.
We know.
Well, then why doesn't the king use their devices on Paul?
He would, but it's too late. They've already been used.
On whom?
I can't tell you.
Sleep long?
No. What time is it?
Going on dawn.
How did it happen?
Don't ask us. It all just started up again. We're checking to see if anything's out of order.
Well, wonders never cease. Any coffee?
No. How about making us some?
Okay.
Never mind, Ellen. I'm not thirsty.
Well, I am, if you don't mind.
You shouldn't have looked in there.
What's the matter with you?
Relax, Ellen. It won't take more than a minute. of at this point. Physical contact with Venus shall be established with consent of the settlements. Paul Nelson shall direct the operation on acquisition of his encephalographic control. I shall remain in contact.
He's finally coming.
What are you going to do?
Why don't you take a walk, Claire? You'll be safe.
After everything I've said, you're still going through with it?
I must. My beliefs haven't changed. I still have to have the courage of my convictions.
Tom, I proved to you that your friend is as weak as you are. He's hiding in a cave, pleading with a human to do his rotten work. He's dead afraid of strength, and that means Paul Nelson. He can't even wait a week to control Paul. That's how frightened he is.
I'm sorry, Claire. I have to go out and meet him.
Look, I don't know whether you can hear me or not, but if you can, you listen good. I hate your living guts for what you've done to my husband and my world. I know you for the coward you are, and I'm going to kill you. Do you hear that? I'm going to kill you.
Took you long enough to get here.
Yeah, long enough. We talk here or inside?
Inside. How's Joan?
She's dead.
What? How?
I killed her.
You killed your wife?
Not my wife. She wasn't my wife. She was a product of your work. A member of the Society of the New World.
You shouldn't have.
I had to.
She was still your wife, still Joan. You would have been one with her if you hadn't...
If I hadn't destroyed the thing that was trying to control me?
Yes.
Well, why shouldn't I destroy it? It was my enemy. You don't seem to realize that we're at war. You made Joan my enemy. My enemy forever, and I had to kill her. My own wife. And now I'm going to kill you.
Go ahead. What good will it do you?
Plenty of good. If I can get to the leaders, to you, to Paddock, to Shallot... The battle will be half won, because apparently this god of yours is immobile. Has to have human beings to carry out his battle orders. Well, I can find people, plenty of them, and we can defeat this thing you call a benefactor.
Perhaps you can. So many things have happened. Joan.
You could help us. You're the only one who knows anything about the invader.
Why don't you kill me and get it over with?
No, no. No, I'm going to get what I can out of you first.
I hear it, Gar. First one I hear all day.
Remarkable. I got worse things to worry about. Like where we're gonna get some rations.
You mean we got nothing to eat?
Not a thing. I got no way to requisition any chow out here. Man, I'm hungry.
I'm hungry, too. How about I go rustle some cows?
No, don't be stupid.
Who's stupid?
You're stupid. Who's got any cows out here?
All right, I'll go rustle some chickens.
This ruler of yours, Tom. You better talk. I'm not afraid to use this.
I don't suppose you are.
Well, at least you're not a coward. There's that much of the human being left in you.
Don't waste flattery on me, Paul. It won't work.
I'm not flattering you. I'm telling you the truth. You think for a minute that one of your controlled people would resist? Oh, not a chance. Courage is an emotion. No, he'd logically conclude that the only way to stay alive would be to talk. You see, pure logic works only for the individual. There's no group feeling, no patriotism, no cooperation of any kind.
What?
You heard me, Tom. The king's playing you for a big sucker. He's using your human emotions, your loyalty, your desire to help your race, your dreams of freedom, everything else you preach to get his own ends. He doesn't feel these things. Somebody else has to do it for him.
Possibility has never occurred to me.
Well, of course it hasn't. We've been too busy waving a non-existent flag.
Look, this thing doesn't have any emotions, therefore it can't understand them. But it does know they exist. And in order to defeat them, it has to use them against things that do have them. Found you, I buttered you up plenty.
He's praised my work.
To keep you working, of course. How could he care anything about you? He doesn't like, he doesn't dislike. He merely reasons, concludes, and uses.
You have what might be a plausible theory. That is, that an emotionless being is helpless when surrounded by beings with emotion, because they'll defend one another, stand together.
As you want Claire to stand with you. But it's no theory, Tom, it's the truth. Have I reached you?
Maybe. Some, I don't know.
Am I still gonna have to kill you?
I was supposed to kill you. His orders.
Suppose he asks you to try again later. Assuming I don't finish you right now.
I don't think I could do it. I'd have to have time to think.
I don't know whether to give you a chance or not.
I've got a rifle over here, but I'm not going to use it. It's gone!
Me destroy it?
I'll get you the installation. Pete and Roy Mason are possessed. Take care of them, I'll go to the Cape. Elephant Hot Springs.
You haven't got a gun.
I'll find something.
Talk English.
I see a monster in a cave. He was killing a girl.
Back up. We're moving out. Far enough.
The plane is on the installation strip.
I have been told. He has ordered me to fly to Washington.
The president will die first.
Then the cabin.
Oh.
inside here.
See, way back in there. He's too big for this little squad, I think.
Bazooka man, set up here and cover the entrance. The rest of you drop packs and fix bayonets. We're going in.
You're on a battlefield.
I know that better than you do, Sergeant. How well are you doing?
Half my men are dead. Nothing can stop that thing.
Call off your troops.
Are you nuts?
I say call them off.
Cease firing!
I made it possible for you to come here. I made you welcome to this earth. You made it the Charno House!
Like he knew it.
He did. He and no one else. He learned almost too late that man is a feeling creature. And because of it, the greatest in the universe. He learned too late for himself that men have to find their own way to make their own mistakes. There can't be any gift of perfection from outside ourselves. When men seek such perfection, they find only death, fire, loss, disillusionment, and the end of everything that's gone forward. Men have always sought an end through toil and misery. It can't be given, it has to be achieved. There is hope, but it has to come from inside. Man himself.